Welcome to the DHS Program video series on tips and tricks to matching data to the DHS Final Report using your statistical software. This video series covers the top 7 reasons why your results might not match the final report. In this video, we will walk through reasons 6 and 7, making sure you are using the correct software-specific code and the correct tabulation. Question 6 is, are you selecting the correct software-specific code? Sometimes the reason your output is not matching the tables could be due to small errors in your coding or syntax. Always make sure to carefully examine your code to minimize these errors. One common coding mistake for not matching DHS final report tables when using the crosstab command in SPSS is not including the count option as is. By default, the SPSS crosstabs command applies weights to each cell, then counts up the number of rounded cases in each cell, resulting in inaccurate total ends. To turn off this option, add count equals as is to your subcommand. Once you add this command, you'll be able to properly match DHS tables. Another tip is always be mindful of your use of upper and lower case letters in variable names, commands, and parameters. For example, SPSS is case insensitive, meaning that you can use any combination of upper and lower case letters in a variable name. However, Stata is case sensitive. The variable name you use in your .do file must match exactly to the variable name in the dataset, or else you will receive an error. Also be aware of how your software program categorizes missing values. For numeric variables, Stata treats missing values as the largest values. SAS treats missing values in numeric variables as the smallest value, and SPSS excludes missing values from conditional statements, but shows the missing values in the results. Always check for missing values before starting on an analysis in a statistical software. And finally, we end with question 7. Are you properly coding the tabulation in your statistical program? One common error among users is accidentally tabulating in the wrong direction. For example, let's look at table 1. This table shows that malaria prevalence is 96% in rural areas. Does this make sense? 96% of the children under 5 who were tested for malaria in rural areas were positive? What do you think the analyst was trying to show with this tabulation? The analyst was trying to show malaria prevalence by urban-rural residents. They were using a row percentage when they should have used a column percentage. We can always tell whether we're looking at a row or column percentage by seeing where the 100% end up. In this table, we can tell that these are row percentages using the distribution of urban-rural residents by their malaria status. Now, let's look at table 2. This table shows that the malaria prevalence among urban children under 5 is 16% and 49% among rural children under 5. We can tell that these are column percentages because the hundreds are at the bottom of the table. Make sure in your programming to use row or column percentages correctly. This video series covers the top 7 reasons why your results might not match the final report. Questions you should ask yourself include, do I have the correct data file, correct denominator, correct variables, correct recoding, correct weights, correct software-specific code, or correct tabulation? If you have run through these questions and you are still unable to match the DHS final report, feel free to leave us a question on the DHS user forum. Additionally, if you would like to practice replicating standard final report tables, please check out the DHS model datasets.